What's up, Tweener Heads? Welcome back to another video. And today, if you're new to the Tweener Head Tennis family, make sure to hit that subscribe button so you don't miss any of our action. And if you want to stay more up to date, hit that notification bell so you don't miss any of it. Today, we are going to be talking about Monica Niculescu. Now, Monica Niculescu, probably none of you, honestly, have heard of her if you're just a casual tennis fan. But if you've been following tennis for some time now, you've probably heard of her once or twice playing a big name player. Monica Niculescu is a veteran Romanian player who plays with such a very unique style of game. If you don't know what I'm talking about, this is what it looks like. While she has such, I don't even know how to describe it, because she has such a flat backhand and such a weird slice of a forehand that you really don't know how she wins. If you just look at her career page, her highest ranking is probably in the top 40s. She hasn't even made it to the top 20s yet, and she's 31 years old, but somehow her Wikipedia page is longer than the Declaration of Independence. The point is, I'm still confused how people play with this unique style, or how people are so individual now within their game that they know how to win. And it's probably the most frustrating thing for me to understand, especially when it comes to tennis. Because traditionally, you have a forehand, you have a backhand, and you have different shots. With Monica, it's just so different that it throws players off for a loop, and that's probably why she got to the quarterfinals of the Wenzhen Open in... Is it Wenzhen? What the fuck am I talking about? Niculescu is currently in the Shenzhen Open, where she's already into the quarterfinals and playing against a woman named Wang. I'm so mature. But when you play people like this, this really makes me wonder how people continuously play like this and continuously win, because you see people with such wacky shots that it really throws you off as a player and makes you frustrated, especially for me, because it astonishes me how someone can be so unique and so talented and yet still not get into the top 30 at least. I don't even know what to say, because it's just, I've never seen anyone play like that. And watching her at the Connecticut Open this past summer, it really shows you like how different everyone's style is. You see people like her with just a slice forehand, and then you see people that have two backhands that make absolutely no sense, but somehow they win. Why? Because they frustrate the shit out of people. It frustrates me. I've played people with two-handed backhands, and I think to myself, wow, this guy is so annoying. What the fuck am I gonna do? And it just blows my mind how people like her win, and how people continuously play like that. I mean, it's great that you can define yourself so early on with such a unique style of play, but when you hit a loopy slice and then a driven backhand, you're telling me that you're not gonna win every time? I think a lot of people don't understand how unique it is, and for me at least, and for sports fans in general, not just sports fans, but tennis fans as well, how people play at this kind of level with such an ability and such a unique style. I'll compare it to baseball. Baseball, you have different stances where people are waiting to at bat, and everyone has a unique stance. Like Gary Sheffield always had his bat moving side to side. Jorge Posada was straight up. Everyone has, even Derek Jeter, I'm a Yankees fan, so all of these come very naturally to me, had a very unique stance where you stand straight up. So it's very interesting to see how people still find success within these levels, because it's not traditional, I would say, because you have every standard. There's always, in baseball, there's a standard stance that you have. It comes naturally. There's a standard forehand. There's the topspin forehand, the backhand. And no one ever, when you use a slice, it's usually defensive, not for an offensive position or attack. So when you see someone like Monica doing this kind of stuff, it really astonishes me how she's either not breaking into the top 40 or she's not out of the top 100. She's good enough to be within the top 100, but not being able to break into it. I mean, 31 years old, she's made over $5 million in her career, and she's made a great living. It amazes me how much she hasn't won and how successful she has been with these crazy shots. I mean, that's just my opinion. If you guys know anyone else with crazy shots or techniques, leave a comment down below of who I should review next. But if you guys enjoyed that video, make sure to leave a like on this video and make sure to subscribe to Tweener Head Tennis as well. If you wanna check us out on all our social medias, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, make sure to do that as well so you don't miss any of the action. And check us out at tweenerheadtennis.com for more behind the scenes content. Hope to see you guys soon. Thanks, guys.